Anladım.
Dear friends, assalamu alaikum. Today our target is the Death Hotelers. It is written, it's a poem written by William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth is one of the most accomplished and influential poets of England. He is a romantic poet and nature poet. In this poem, The Daffodils, he highlights the beauty of nature and tells us that nature is one of the best companions who provides him joy and happiness. So first of all, let me tell you what is a daffodil. What are daffodils? Daffodils are yellow, trumpet shaped flowers having a long stem that bloom in spring. There are usually found at the fringe of lakes and ponds. Once William Wordsworth was upset. He was wandering lonely as a cloud. As he himself says, I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills. It is page number 27 of our textbook, Chinarpas. I wandered lonely as a cloud. Wandered means moved around. Wordsworth says that I was moving around all alone, like a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills. He compares himself. He has used the poetic device of simile. He compares his loneliness. He compares himself like a cloud that floats high, that sails, floats means sails, on high or whales, whales means valleys and hills in the sky. When all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, flirting and dancing in the breeze. In this stanza, Wordsworth says that once he was moving around, he was wandering around, lonely, like a cloud sailing in the sky, floating over vales and hills. But just then, he reached a spot, he reached a place, he reached a lake, and on the banks of that very lake, he saw what? He saw a crowd. A crowd. A crowd means so many, innumerable. He saw a crowd of golden daffodils. He saw numerous daffodils growing on the banks of that lake. He has used mentioned here, host. He has personified here. He has used the poetic device of personification. When we attribute human qualities, human characteristics to animals, plants or other animate or inanimate creatures, that technique is used as known as personification. Personification. Host, guest. When you visit somebody's house, he welcomes you, you are called a guest. And when he welcomes you honestly, serves you, feeds you, provides you comfort, you are called host. Here, Wordsworth has personified daffodils as host. Because he says that when he was lonely, he needed the support. He was wandering all alone like a cloud, floating high over the sky, floating the sky, high over vales and hills. He reached the support. He observed the daffodils. The daffodils welcomed him. They told him, "Come on, Mr. Wordsworth." They greeted him. So he has used the term host here for a daffodils. Here he has personified daffodils. What were the daffodils doing? He says, beside the lake, beneath the trees, these daffodils were growing. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, they were growing below the trees. What were they doing? They were fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Breeze means air and air in slow motion. Air in cold breeze means, when air is moving slowly, we call it breeze. And that way, breeze. These daffodils were moving around. They were fluttering. They were moving. And dancing. Yes, who dances? It is not animals don't dance. Plants don't dance. It is the quality of we humans who dance. So here, Wordsworth has also used the technique of personification. He has personified these daffodils. Their daffodils were dancing. They were dancing. Can daffodils dance? No, they can't dance. But daffodils have given them this characteristic of humans that they dance. They were flirting. They were moving. Daffodils can't move. But he said that in the cold breeze, their heads, their this upper part of their body, their flowers, their branches, they were moving this way and this way. So he says they were fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Now, sentence number second. Continuous as stars that shine and typical on the Milky Way. They stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads and sprightly dance. Wordsworth says, continuous as stars that shine. Stars are, there are numerous stars in the sky. We can't count them. We can't count them. So Wordsworth says, there were so many, there were numerous daffodils growing. They were in full bloom beside the lake, beneath the trees. As stars on the sky, so were the daffodils in the lake. And typical on the Milky Way. Milky Way is our nearest galaxy. A large number of stars are there. He compares these daffodils like a Milky Way. Yes. He says, in Milky Way there are numerous stars. So there are numerous daffodils growing there beside the lake beneath the trees on the bank of that lake. As stars are twinkling, so were twinkling, so were shining these daffodils. They stretch a never ending line. Stretch means separate. Stretch means separate. They stretch it. They separate a never ending line. There was one daffodil. There was another daffodil. They stretch it. They were composing a vast area. They were going in a vast area. They spread over a vast area in never ending line. Where they spread? Along the margin of a bay. Along the margin of that lake. Then he says, here you will hear another quote technique, that is hyperbole. Hyperbole means exaggeration. Exaggeration. Which we call bada character pesh karna. Yes. 10,000 saw I at a glance. At one glance I saw 10,000. You know that William Wordsworth had never counted them. But he used the technique of hyperbole here. He says, I saw 10,000 aliens. Tossing their heads. They were tossing their heads. And sobriety dance. Sobriety means happy dance. Sobriety means happy dance. They were dancing. The devotees were dancing happily. And they were tossing their heads this way and this way. They were greeting me. They served as ghost to me. I was very upset. I was unhappy. But the sight of these daffodils relieved my unhappiness, relieved my tension. I became, they made me happy. They made me happy. They were tossing their heads. Tossing. It is we humans who can toss their heads. But he said, they are daffodils were tossing their heads. So here he has personified. The poet has used the technique of personification, tossing their heads. Tossing their heads. He has personified daffodils here. The waves beside me, beside them danced, but they avoided the sparkling waves and gilly. Gilly means happiness. Wordsworth says that when the daffodils were dancing, the waves in the lake, they too were dancing. All were dancing. Daffodils were dancing. Waves were dancing. But they avoided the sparkling waves in gilly. When one is happy, he dances. And unhappy man never dances. So dance is symbol of happiness. Dance is symbol of happiness. Tossing of heads is sign of happiness. He says, Wordsworth says, that daffodils were dancing. Waves too in the lake were dancing. But the daffodils overpowered the waves in their dance. They surpassed the waves in their happy dance. The dance of daffodils was more powerful. It was more quick and swift and fast as compared to the dance of waves. A poet could not be but gay. Gay is also, gilly is happy. Gilly means happy. Gay means happy. A poet could not be but gay in such a jocund company. Jocund company means happy company. Jocund company means
happy
company. Jocund company. He said that I Wordsworth, a poet, couldn't remain unhappy in the company of that happy creatures, happy waves, happy daffodils. I too became happy. Though in the beginning when I arrived at the spot, I was unhappy. I was moving around like a cloud that floats high over valleys and hills in the sky. But the sight of daffodils, the sight of daffodils who were tossing their heads, who were dancing, who were flirting, and the waves in the lake, they too were dancing. Their dance changed my mood. I became happy. I couldn't remain unhappy in the jocund company, in the happy company of those flowers, those daffodils. I gazed and gazed by little thought. Gaze means looked cautious continuously. He says that I continuously looked upon the sight, upon the beautiful sight, upon the scenic beauty of lake and daffodils, and thought what wealth the show to me had brought. Wordsworth says that I looked continuously over the daffodils, over the beautiful sight, and thought that they had enriched my emotions. They had given me wealth. What wealth? Not wealth in material sense, not wealth in terms of money and clothes and property, but the best wealth is happiness. The sight of daffodils provided him happiness, and happiness is the wealth. It is the best wealth. They enriched emotions. So in that very sense, Wordsworth says that this beautiful sight of daffodils provided him wealth. For oft when on my couch I lie, couch means bed, Wordsworth says that it was a bygone days. Now the days have gone, those days have gone. When I visited that very spot, when I was wandering lonely like a cloud, he says, for often, he says, when often I lay on my bed, when at night I am sleeping in my bed, in vacant or fancy mood, vacant means idle mood, idle, vacant. Idle or pensive mood means thoughtful state of mind. When I am in thoughtful state of mind, whenever I am in tension, what does it say? When at night I am lying in bed, I am idle and in a state of tension, in a thoughtful state of mind, they flash upon that inward eye. Suddenly I recollect my memory and think of that day when I visited the spot, when I was greeted by the crowd of golden daffodils, which is the bliss of solitude. And in that, so when I recollect my memory and think of that bygone day, when I enjoyed the company of those daffodils, they flashed upon the inward eye. Suddenly they appeared before my eyes. In imagination, that sight appeared before my eyes, which is the bliss of solitude. Solitude means loneliness. Solitude means solitude. And by recollecting that sight, my mood again changes, and I again became happy. And then my heart with pleasure fills. Then my heart becomes happy and dance with the daffodils. And then I again begin to dance with the daffodils in imagination. Whenever, what is it says that whenever he is unhappy, whenever he is in tension, lying in his bed, in idleness, he remembers that scene of daffodils. Suddenly, in imagination, those daffodils, the lack appear before him, and his mood changes, and he again begins to dance with daffodils, and his heart is filled with pleasure. Thanks, stay blessed, have a nice day.